Here in the Kurzgesagt Labs, we test very important ideas to see what
massive fail. Thanks. Thank you. We'll probably just keep that bit in anyway somehow.
Happens when you blow things up or play with black holes. Many of you suggested that we look into an idea that sounds reasonable. Shooting nuclear waste into space. It's one of those concepts that seems like an easy...
We just messed this up. This will be on YouTube now. So, as we were just saying with a very Australian accent, this is not a good idea. A lot of Aussies think, you know, not Aussies, just people in general. Why don't we just launch it into the sun or just out into space and just forget about it? Well, you're going to find out. It's not that easy. There's some fundamental problems.
A fix for one of the main problems with the nuclear energy. But it turns out this idea is not just bad, but horribly bad. And it gets worse the longer you think about it. Why is that?
Let's just launch it into space, mate. Straight into the sun. Just be done with it. And that's that.
What is nuclear waste? Nuclear waste is a fuzzy term and comes in categories which vary from country to country.
America.
But in general, there are three broad levels. 90% is low-level nuclear waste, tools, gloves, or trash used at a nuclear facility that could be weakly contaminated with some short-lived radioactivity.
This stuff's pretty safe.
Stuff is generally safe for normal disposal. 7% is intermediate level nuclear waste, mostly materials that have been in close proximity to a reactor core long enough to become dangerously radioactive.
Big D is in the house, welcome.
With proper handling, it's either safely buried or melted down and mixed into glass or concrete and stored deep underground.
This was the intermediate, yes.
So 97% of nuclear waste is similar to toxic byproducts from other industries. Not great, not terrible. We can handle it.
Not that bad.
The remaining 3% is where our problems begin.
Yes.
High-level nuclear waste is very concentrated spent fuel taken out of a reactor core. Formerly...
Yeah, as well as the rods themselves.
Uranium, it's now made of various dangerous and often highly radioactive elements. As a bonus, it's also incredibly hot and not easy to handle at all.
I love the animations these guys do. They just... entertain me so much.
This is what we want to shoot into space. All in all, around 400 and...
We're going to explain how that animation is somewhat not accurate as to why this is a big problem, but I get it. They're just trying to make it fun.
40 active nuclear reactors.
Another interesting thing is like how he said he's talking about the nuclear waste when it's spent. Well, it's pretty interesting that we only some of the stuff, you know, has still... We could keep using it, but we have all these treaties and rules about how much you can spend some of this material. And it's amazing, like, we only spend in some cases like 5% of what's really there, so there's still like 95% we could. But, you know, people are just scared of this stuff. I think these things will slowly change when people realize nuclear fission and nuclear reactors are much safer than we realize. But anyway, we can talk about this in a minute.
Create about 11,000 tons of high level nuclear waste each year. Since 1954, we've accumulated 400,000 tons of dangerous radioactive waste. Most countries are dealing with it by not dealing with it and kicking the can towards the future. Great, so let's launch it into space. According to scientists, space is big and nobody lives there, so it seems perfect for yeeting away this mess.
Yeet.
There are a few tiny problems though. Problem one, stuff ain't cheap.
There's so many problems, and I want to address all of them. I want to see if he brings them up first.
Even though spaceflight is getting more affordable, it's still extremely expensive. Just to get something into low Earth orbit costs on average about $4,000 per kilogram. Putting that into perspective, it costs about $1,600 to mine, separate, and fabricate 1 kilogram of nuclear fuel, so launching waste into space has suddenly made nuclear fuel for reactors way more expensive and greatly increased the cost of the electricity they produce. To launch one reactor...
He's kind of missing a fundamental issue here, so let's see if he addresses it.
...worth of nuclear waste would cost at least $100 million per year. To deal with all the 440 operational nuclear power plants, high-level nuclear waste would cost some $44 billion per year for space launch before packaging, transport, and security costs are added. Okay, let's pretend we don't care. Currently, we couldn't shoot all the nuclear waste into space even if we wanted to. There just aren't enough rockets. In 2021, we saw a record 135 launches into space. If we repurposed each...
Okay, so I'm not sure he's going to mention it just from skipping it, looking at these. So there is the other problem where that, you know, this stuff, you know, one of the lighter elements this stuff can turn into after you use it is, you know, that stuff called lead, right? It's not exactly light. So it's not exactly... You probably know that, you know, when you shoot things into... Try to, at least, into orbit. It's not easy, clearly. You know, you can't... It's probably harder to launch heavier things, right? So just think about that. You know, you're just going to add all this lead to a rocket ship. That's not going to be easy. That's going to be very, very hard. And it's going to cost a lot of money. So, but there's so many other issues. We're going to get there. Guess what, guys? The version 1.2 of the thing I've been creating that can protect you from quantum computers is here. So this is what you're looking at right now, it working. And this is going to be really important going forward. I've created the world's first post-quantum VPN that you guys can use. So yeah, if you want to come support me as well and protect yourself from the future, because hackers might be able to retroactively hack people, and you might think, oh, I'm no one important. That's not going to matter. But governments, people could be stealing a lot of data, VPN encrypted data from everyone, to decrypt in a few short years when they can run our Shor's algorithm on a decently sized quantum computer, and that's coming. So
those rockets and filled them all with nuclear waste, the total amount that could be lifted into a low Earth orbit, which is the closest orbit above the atmosphere, is nearly 800 tons. We'd need at least 14 times more rockets to handle just today's nuclear waste, let alone get rid of the hundreds of thousands of tons in temporary storage.
So he's kind of starting at issues that are kind of non-issues when you compare them to the actual big issues, which make this just sort of not even worth thinking about it in this way, at least. But
we would need to create entire new space industries to keep up with the demand for giant, toxic space trash trucks. And it gets worse.
Much worse.
Problem two, space is hard. We only made the calculation for low Earth orbit, where we send most of our rockets and satellites. Littering the space around...
So, yeah, you can start to see.
...Earth with thousands of casks of spent nuclear fuel would be a nightmare for space junk management and satellite collision avoidance. Worse still, at this altitude,
there are treaties against this sort of thing.
A little bit of atmosphere causing a tiny bit of drag, so we might have nuclear waste raining down from space within just a few years. Experts would call this a huge problem. Clearly, we have to launch our waste further. If we wanted to send it to, perhaps, the moon, we either need way more rockets, or we need to build much bigger ones, making it even more expensive. A single Saturn V, the rocket used by the Apollo program, which cost around $1.5 billion adjusted for inflation per launch, could get about 43.5 tons from the Earth to the moon. So we'd need about 260 Saturn V rocket launches every year. And of course, using the moon as target practice for nuclear waste-tipped rockets kind of makes a huge mess. So maybe don't aim for anything. Space is empty. Do we really need a target? Shooting waste in any random direction is, you guessed it, also a bad idea. Orbits are loops, which means...
Okay, so before we get here, let me weigh in a little bit, and then we'll continue, and I'll keep weighing in after watching a little bit. But, so yeah, as he pointed out here, you know, if you were to shoot at a planet, obviously not good for the planet, if we ever want to set up a colony there. You could bury it, these things on planets. I think that will be a good option in the distant future. Not too distant. But basically, launching things into space takes... You know, I already told you, just to get to orbit with lots of lead on your rocket ship is going to be tough. Now trying to launch it into somewhere and, you know, actually out there is going to be really hard. You're going to need, as he just showed, all those Saturn Vs if you were to try and do all of the stuff we're producing. But forget about that, right? Generally, when you launch things into space, into an orbit, they have a nasty habit of coming back. There's a famous story of an astronomer discovering this asteroid that was kind of heading toward Earth back in like early 2000s, I think it was. And anyway, they figured out eventually that this was actually a booster from Apollo 14 or 12. It was one of them. and it was coming back after 30 years. It would just launch out there, went on a nice little journey around the sun, It was coming back for us. And then so we pushed it out again. Unfortunately, this thing is going to eventually come back again, because this is what happens with orbits. In about, I think it's about 240 years, it's going to be another problem for us. And it's going to probably crash into Earth. It won't be too bad, don't worry. Mostly ocean, right? So that's going to happen. So that's a little story as to, you know, shooting stuff into space, not a good idea. Shooting stuff into the sun might sound like a good idea, but, you know, to do that would require a lot of energy, and it's way harder than it sounds. You can't just simply do that.
They have a tendency to come back to where they started. Put enough in the sky in random directions, and you'll get one back eventually. So we'd want to launch...
So what we can do, I guess, is we'll put these... I don't think it's the video, I think it's the sound. So I'll just leave the comments up, and we'll turn the sound off. Pretty sure it's the song. Not that we would be completely safe then. Earth might run into these interplanetary caskets, as I just demonstrated, sometime in the far future, experiencing a much... experience a pretty meteor shower. Pretty but deadly. But how about we shoot it into the sun? Ironically, the sun is pretty hard to hit. Yes, as I just told you.
The sun has very strong gravity. Everything...
Just keep in mind, guys, if it goes down again, it comes back in like a minute. I think we lost a bunch of people, but that's okay.
Moving with respect to the sun, including the rockets that we launch, meaning a rocket would have to cancel out all the orbital motion it has around the sun.
Yes.
And fall in. Easier to launch a rocket entirely out of the solar system than it is to launch it in.
It is, but it's also not easy.
Of these things, we need even bigger rockets, probably the biggest we've ever built. Nothing works.
It's got to be this song. Still gets much worse. Oh yeah, it gets worse. We have made them relatively safe. They're always doing mean things to ducks. Liquid oxygen. Kerosene, the newest designs even land themselves so that they can be reused. Thanks to SpaceX. And yet, out of the 146 launches in 2021, there are 11 failures, which means they're sizable. And yet, a number of our rockets carrying high-level radioactive waste would explode. Yep, not good. Launch pad, in the worst case. Rapid disassembly, as Elon likes to call it, crashing from hypersonic speeds. Each failure would be at least equivalent to a mini Chernobyl. No, it would be way worse. That'll be it for the curves. I'll just look the topics here and I'll chat about them. So rockets go burr. We just talked about why that's potentially bad. You also got to remember that there are some treaties against, like, you know, launching nuclear bombs in space, if you didn't know, which is annoying because we could actually build some starships that could travel to, you know, interstellar travel with nukes. You could, like a putt-putt boat, you could build a starship and sequentially explode nuclear bombs behind it. And this would actually accelerate, if you do it in the right way, this ship, to you could get it near the speed of light. Not quite the speed of light, but you could get it going very quickly, right? And people did some calculations like back in the 70s and 80s. And this thing could actually circumnavigate the observable universe in about 56 years ship time if you could create one of these things. So how crazy is that? You could, I'm trying to remember the stats. That's the, because you got to remember time dilation. So distance contracts when you go near the speed of light. So for the ship itself, for everyone else, you know, if you were to take that round journey, by the time you get back, you're billions of years in the future and the sun is long dead. Let's get rid of this. So anyway, that's a tangent. So nuclear bombs, I was just mentioning that it's a shame because I can't think of a better way to use nuclear bombs. So you know how everyone's always saying, oh, there's no reason to have a there's zero reason we should have nuclear bombs on our planet. Well, actually, there's lots of reasons that they could be useful. For instance, an interstellar ship. That'd be brilliant. But unfortunately, everyone's scared of these things and no one likes to think, and they're like, let's ban them. Let's get rid of all of them. And there's a bunch of hairless monkeys around here that can't seem to, you know, take their hand away from the big button that goes boom. Not looking at anyone in North Korea. Obviously, they don't have them. I mean, they were testing them, weren't they, actually? Sorry. So, yeah, that is a problem.